The next song that I want to talk about is the song Why Georgia by John Mayer. So what we'll do is we'll play the first verse to this song, and then I'll tell you what it is about this song that I learned about great lyric writing. About lyric writing from this song, I really learned from songwriting teacher Andrea Stolpe, who's written a great book called Popular Lyric Writing. And what she talks about in that book is the difference between internal language and external language, and how important it is to achieve a balance of internal and external. So external language is really the language of description and scene setting, so that we have a vivid and specific picture of an actual character in an actual space. We get a sense of the physical world of the song. So in this song, the lines, "I'm driving up 85, is pure external. It tells us situational narrative detail. It situates the singer of the song in a physical space. We can see him. And then we have the line, "in the kind of morning that lasts all afternoon." Now, this starts to blend external with internal. So internal language is the language of thought and feeling, reflection and insight. It's emotional language. It's not necessarily tied to something physical. It's describing an emotional state or a thought. So there's a bit of external with reference to the morning, that's something vivid and specific, but the kind of morning that lasts all afternoon is a thought, right? That's explaining some way that it feels. So that's a blend of external and internal. And then we get a pure internal line, just stuck inside the gloom. So that is just describing an emotional state. So already we have this pattern of external, mixed language, internal, and then the same pattern repeats in this song. "Four more exits to my apartment, pure external." "But I am tempted to keep the car and drive." It's a blend, because "I'm tempted" is an emotional statement. "To keep the car and drive" tells us something physical, brings us back to the situation. "And leave it all behind." Now that's pure internal, because it's just telling us what the thought of the character is. So again, when we look at the pattern of this song, we have external mixed internal, external mixed internal. Now, this is a pure balanced blend of external and internal. But what is the effect? Why would we do this? Well, as songwriters, we have very limited time to engage and connect with a listener and make them care enough about the song. The thing about external language is that when you conjure imagery, it is actually one of the fastest ways to connect to a listener. If they can see the singer or the character of the song in a physical place, it's like they're in a movie scene, right? It's like a good opening scene of a movie. You immediately suspend your disbelief. You're right there. And it opens the door to the feeling. But then blending it with the internal language gives us an immediate sense of why we care. And not only that, in this particular song, we are given the sense of the emotional crisis of the song in that first verse. So we really understand what the fundamental problem is for this character driving, literally and metaphorically, the whole kind of narrative of this song. So this idea of blending external and internal language is something that I learned from this song and something that I strive to achieve in every one of my songs. I want listeners to know in my first verse, sometimes even in the first two lines, to be honest, of a song, not only to get a sense of what the imagery is, get a sense of a physical space, but to understand what the emotional problem, tension, or conflict is that is driving the need to sing this song in the first place.